back to the show, guys. And today here, I have an artist, not from Kenya, not from Africa, but from South America. I'm just going to let him introduce himself so that you guys can see. I'm not lying, by the way. There is someone else here with me, so I don't think I'm lying. So, guys, let me introduce to you the Latin American. He's going to say his name and introduce himself and tell us what he does, what music he does. Okay. Hi, welcome to the show.
Hi, thank you. I'm honored for this invitation. Mm-hmm. I want to say Saseni to Kenya. That is what I learned too.
Saseni, Saseni. Yeah. There's also Habari Yako.
Habari Yako, Kenya.
Jambo.
Jambo.
The famous one, Jambo.
Yeah, I'm happy mm-hmm. to be here to share mm-hmm. with all of you.
Yeah.
We have there are four names. Okay. So I simplify with one name that is Iguazu. That is a river that unites South America.
Iguazu. Do you know Iguazu sounds like a Kenyan name? That's what I wanted to ask. Are you Kenyan? Yeah, it sounds like a Kenyan name. Iguazu. It goes like some western, from a western part of Kenya. Okay, okay. Iguazu?
Iguazu, yes. Mm-hmm. And basically, I do music oriented to education, or can I say social oriented? Mm-hmm. Since father responsibility, protection of the environment, God at the center of everything, mm-hmm. of any controversy and anything, God yeah. in the middle of the God of the love. I always used to say that God is that is that of love, mm-hmm. not of any sentiment different.
True, true, true. So how did you start singing? Tell me your journey. How did you know, like, I can sing?
Okay, when I was 7 years old, mm-hmm. My family, I am the last born of 8 children.
8?
Yeah.
Wow. I'm the only kid. Okay.
And uh-huh. my father, uh-huh. my biological father is yeah. Afro descendant.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and it's my mother who was a little bit more the other color, more light.
Yeah.
That's why if you see all of us sitting together each other, you may not think that we are brothers and sisters. And
oh, there's someone who are dark, others who are lighter. So,
yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So all of them constitute bands mm-hmm. since I was very young. And then they put me to sing as a soloist in the, yeah.
Okay.
In the bands of my family. There I started. Then I when I went to high school, finishing high school, I was mm-hmm. registering violin. Mm-hmm. And I was part of the youth and the children orchestra of my village. And in that way I started, I reached the university, I started to win the Festival of Voice there. Mm-hmm. Then I was during Festival of Voice, then I continued until I can sing.
So you can also play music. Instruments, musical yeah. instruments. Yeah. The violin, what
the
else?
Violin.
Only the violin.
Only the violin, pandeiro, which is a Brazilian instrument, mm-hmm. that is the tambourine that they are called pandeiro.
Ah, okay. Yeah. So how did you get into gospel music? Okay, let me start with gospel music and then the environmental. How did you get into that? Because most people usually just sing.
Yeah,
Kenya, they don't recognize like God or anything in it.
I think that Kenya mm-hmm. has a special bless mm-hmm. because when I reached here was when I started to compose gospel song.
Okay.
And there I want to give a testimony for the youth.
Yeah.
When I was doing marathon in my country.
Yeah,
I'm
you're
a runner.
Okay.
Of long distance.
We call them here Kalenjins. Jacket. People for jacket.
I know them. Yeah. They really run.
Yes, they do run.
So, and I won a marathon in Callao.
Okay.
Con Avaridi.
Oh.
Then I was training. That was 25 kilometers. Okay. But then I was training for Lewa Marathon.
Yeah, okay.
And in my training, an accident happened that a car crashed me and I was in bed rest. To make the story short, I have fracture of the pelvic area.
No.
And the doctors were in the bed telling that you will walk, but after mm-hmm. 4 years. In fact, the doctors didn't want to give me the news because it was very devastating. He's a runner and he will really break down. So, okay, to tell you the truth, son, you cannot, for 4 years, you have to be in bed rest.
Okay.
And then you will have to be 2 years in wheelchair and 2 years using crutches.
Uh-huh.
But the matter of fact is that in 4 months, I walk.
Oh, okay, that is good.
So mm-hmm. when I have been under the Kenyan, I can say that I live under a roof of a church,
yeah,
because Kenyans are very committed with Christianity and with religion.
Yeah.
So basically, there is something that I really like that you, Kenyan, there are, one of the three questions that you always ask, Amanda, is with which church do you attend?
To? Yeah.
Yeah. So that's very important. So there was a brother of mine that was in the bed rest that mm-hmm. in the first week that went to visit to me and told me, okay, we have to take you to the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
And they said, we have to call the ambulance, though the wheelchair is there. And then I say, okay, what do you think if I try? And then my brother pastor closed the door and said, okay, yeah, try, but if it hurts, don't continue.
Oh, okay.
And then I said, well, they say that, keep in saying that faith is that power from the Lord that you
exactly.
don't see, but it is there. And I said, okay, try. And I couldn't move at all. They had even to raise me up to put me in the small bed to take me to the ambulance.
Yeah.
And I just started to pull the blanket on my, of course, with a little bit of pain, mm-hmm. to pull the blanket. And in 5 minutes, I sat down and my brother, the pastor, was shocked looking at me. And he said, now can you stand up? I said, okay, God help me. They come near to me, mm-hmm. and I just started to pull his shirt. And I woke up to where he was, because uh-huh. he sat me down in the wheelchair. He uh-huh. brought me to the rest, to the hospital, and put me in front of the doctor. Doctor, I want you to see something. He said, okay, stand up. When I stand up, the doctor jumped. And he told me, son, sit down, because I have to tell you something. I have neither read about it. Mm-hmm. I have neither studied, neither listened about it. You couldn't have been walking for normal reason.
Okay.
This is a miracle, because it doesn't have another name.
Oh.
So, believe in God, because God cannot never leave you in any bad situation. After that accident, it's when I composed my first gospel song. Mm-hmm. And the song say that when you are praying, God immediately will show up from heaven, mm-hmm. and he will send you a lift. But when you take that lift and you are in the middle of there and you see that you don't have floor, because the prayers have that power to elevate you mm-hmm. near to Father, when you see yourself in the air and nothing is under your feet, don't doubt, because with God you will never fall down.
I hope, guys, you've had the message. I'm not going to repeat it, because he's just saying it so well and I'm blown away, and that is good. So now, after that, you came while you're in Kenya. That's how you composed your first song.
Yes, and actually it's so magic, and God is so powerful. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's exactly the same example when Jesus was walking in the water, and Peter saw, he said, Jesus, I want to go where you are. And he said, just come. And when he started to doubt, he calmed down. I composed a song, and I constitute a group called Dance for a Degree, that mm-hmm. we are going there. If you have a problem with your fees and you cannot rise up, your parents are having a very bad problem,
mm-hmm.
you call us, I will send you one of my dancers. They will train you to the concert of the length that you want.
Mm-hmm.
You organize your concert, you take your entrance ticket, and all the incomes will go to pay your university fees, not
That's
for us.
That's a good initiative right now.
When I started to do that, the CEO of the Kenya Gospel Award got into contact with me through another person and told me, do you want to participate in an event? Say yes. He said, do you know which event are you going to? I said, no. But he said, everything that comes from God is so spectacular and so fascinating that it's not announced before and it appears like that. So that I want to see there when I arrive there, and I saw this is the Gospel Award. So that's God for you.
Ah, okay. I can see that. So apart from the gospel song, what other songs do you have?
Okay, there is one called Save the World,
mm-hmm.
that it is telling that if you go to the university, if you go to high school, just to take one exam and to approve it,
mm-hmm.
you may not fulfill completely the purpose of your institution or what the society is expecting.
Mm-hmm.
The only way you can save the world, you can save the humanity, is that as soon as you are studying, don't memorize, analyze what you are reading, because mm-hmm. many of the instruments to save the world from pollution are already in the books we have left behind, just to take an exam and to approve.
And why the pollution? Why focus on the environment? Why that?
Okay, nowadays, And that's when Kenya become more important as well. Mm-hmm. Kenya is the base of United Nations Habitat. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the program for United Nations Program for Environment Protection, PNUMA, we call it in our language. If you see nowadays, the pollution have become a global problem. When we talk about globalization, it's because every time more, if I burn something in South America, you cannot think that the people in Africa are not suffering, because it will go to there, and all of us share what the Mother Earth has. This is the common house. So now, every time that globalization, every time take more up, we must realize that we are more together. Yeah. So we are only one, and it's the time to protect each other, because the way Mother House is going on the earth, that is the only roof that God has keep us while we are on earth, is going from worse to worse, and the only people who can save it is us through education.
Wow, that was a lot, guys. So let's go for a music break, and we'll come back with more from Iguasu. I think I said it. Did I say it like a Nigerian? Let's go for a music break.